Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we will try to understand resistance and memory unit of a basic computer. In our previous video, we have seen the design of the basic computer. There we have discussed that it consists of 8 resistors and 1 memory unit. We will try to have the detailed understanding of each and every resistor, the size of each and every resistor, the name of each and every resistor, and the operation that is performed by each and every resistor. We will try to understand in this class, and apart from that, we will try to understand what is a memory unit. So what it consists of, what is the size of that memory unit, and how the addressing is done. So all those concepts we will try to understand in this class. Now coming to this class, we are having 8 resistors. The resistors are PC, program counter resistor, and the size of this resistor is 12 bits. And the other resistor is address resistor, it is the size of 12 bits, instruction resistor, temporary resistor, data resistor and accumulator. These 4 resistors are of size 16 bits. And OTR and INPR, which is output resistor and input resistor, both these resistors are of size 8 bits. So what is the job done by this each and every resistor? So the data resistor holds the memory operand. For example, if we want to add 2 plus 3, so the 2 is what we call it as 2 and 3 are called as operands. So the operand values will get stored, the data values will get stored in the data resistor. Address resistor holds the address of the memory. So the memory addresses we will try to understand later, so in this video. So address resistor is capable of holding memory addresses. So the address of each and every word of this memory will get stored in the address resistor. So that is the reason why it is 12 bits resistor. Why 12 bit resistor? That also we will try to understand in the next coming in few minutes. Okay, the other one is accumulator, processor resistor. This is the resistor used by the processor. So the contents of the contents that are done by the addition, the arithmetic operations that are done on the ALU will be transferred onto accumulator. Next is instruction resistor, which holds the instructions. Program counter holds the address of instruction. So where the instruction is located in the memory, that address is located in program counter. Temporary resistor holds temporary data. So whenever we need a temporary data to be stored somewhere else, so it will get stored in temporary resistor. Input resistor holds input character. So the characters are of size 8 bits. So the input characters will get stored in input resistor, and similarly the output character will get stored in output resistor. So these are the different types of resistors that are available. We suggest you to remember all these terminology. So what is DR means data resistor, AR means address resistor. So thoroughly try to remember this terminology. We will get habituated to this terminology in our later coming videos. Now coming to this, coming to the memory unit. So what this memory unit is? This is the memory unit. We have already discussed that the memory unit, this memory unit is what we call it as RAM, random access memory. So it is not a hard disk, it is RAM. And what are the features of this RAM? Features of this RAM means it consists of 4096 words. So what is meant by a word? Word is a group of bits. That are used by the processor. So those group of bits are used by the processor, and 16 bits per word. So how many bits do we have per word? We are going to have 16 bits per word, and we are having 4096 words. Okay, so this number is a bit bigger to understand. What we will do is we will just simplify the concepts. We will take 8 words, 16 bit per word memory. So this is the memory. The visualization of the memory will be in this way. So this memory is having 8 words. See here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, total of 8 words. And each word is of size. So this is what we call it as oats, group of bits used by the processor. Okay, so it is a 16-bit word. Each word, we are having 8 words, so each word is going to be 16-bit size. So the total number of bits is, the total number of bits are 8 by 16, so 8 into 16. Okay, so these many number of bits are there. Okay, so this is a 8 word memory with 16 bits per word. So these are the 16 bits per word, and we are having 8 words. Okay, so now how to give the address of each and every word. So each and every word has to be identified uniquely. So that unique identification, each and every memory word has to be identified uniquely. How that unique identification is provided, is as we have 8 words, 2 power 3. So the size of the address, so 2 power 3 is equal to 8. So 8 words can be uniquely identified with 3 bits. See here, 8 different words can be uniquely identified. Each and every word is uniquely identified with 3 bits. 2 power 3 is 8 bits. So the size of the address is, 3 bits. So the unique code that is given for this address is 000 binary address. It is 000 001 010 011 100 101 101 and this is 111. So each and every address of these locations is provided with an unique code, and the size of that unique code is what we call it as the size of that unique code is 3 bits. Okay, so hope you got this understanding. So how the unique addresses are provided. Okay, the unique addresses are provided by the 2 powers of number of words that are available. So what this memory is stating is this: we have in our computer, we have a memory of size 4096 words. As we have 8 words here, in this memory we have 4096 words. Okay, so the address, the first address is going to be 0 and 1, 2. Similarly, it is 4095. So how each and every address is uniquely identified, it is 2 power 12 is equal to 4096. 2 power 12 is equal to 4096. So what is the number of bits that are used to uniquely identify each and every word is what we call it as address bit. So number of bits in the address, that is what we call it as address, right? So the number of bits in the address are 12 bits. So each and every word, each and every memory location is uniquely identified by using 12 bits. Okay, so in order to simplify those terms, we have taken this example. So that is the reason why PC, what is this PC? PC is a program counter, holds address of an instruction. Because these registers are capable of storing addresses, are used for storing addresses, the size of this register is 12 bits. Why only 12 bits is the addresses are represented, all the addresses are uniquely represented by using 12 bits. So this logic is very important to understand. Okay, so and one more register, that is address register. Address register holds the address of memory. So the address of the memory, means any one of these. So the address is of size 12 bits. That is the reason why we have taken the address register as a 12 bit register. Okay, so these are the different types of registers, and this is how the memory of the computer, basic computer, will be. So this is what we would like to discuss in this class. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol and please share this video with your friends so that they will also get benefited. Thanks for watching.